you know, when you study parasites, you start seeing the world in a really interesting way, because instead of seeing, you know, I always loved plants and animals, but now I started to see them not just as that animal on its own, but about like each animal becomes an ecosystem for all of the other things that live on it. And I think that is like an endlessly interesting way to look at the world. It's like those Russian stacking dolls, right? So if you see a shark swim by, I don't just think, oh, cool shark. Now I'm like, oh, there might be copepods living on its skin. Oh, I wonder if it has tapeworms in its intestine. Oh, I wonder if it has isopods in its nostrils. Oh, like, you know, because it turns out there's more than 2,000 species of parasites that live on sharks. And so every animal, you know, and the same thing goes with a deer walking down, you know, walking through the woods. It could have fleas and ticks and tapeworms and all sorts of things living in and on it. And so you start seeing the world as like this kaleidoscope or like multi-layered place where every object, every creature in it is a habitat for smaller things that are living in and on it. And I think that just becomes like a really cool way of looking at the world. If you study a mammal, for instance, or study any organism, part of the time you're going to spend studying that organism's environment, right? Because that's like so important for how organisms work. But when you study a parasite, that parasite's environment is a whole other organism that you also get to study. So like studying parasites is super cool. And I became pretty hooked on that.
That makes a lot of sense. It's really curious too, because I look at the world through the microscope, and I just actually finished writing an article for the conservation area where I usually go get my sample. They asked me to write an article for their blog. And I was writing in there and saying how, you know, looking at this little microscopic, I put all my samples in a petri dish. I'm not like you. I'm way too impatient. I put it in a petri dish. I put it under the scope. And what I notice is that, like you said, it's a whole other ecosystem. You see creatures being born. You see creatures eating each other. Mm-hmm. You see scavenger ciliates eating, you know, whatever's left of a molt. You see all this beautiful stuff, and you forget about yourself. You forget about your ego. You forget about all the human things happening outside of wherever you are, your desk, your living room, your lab. And it is, I mean, I can see the appeal. I can definitely see the appeal in, like you said, studying not just the natural world, but studying parasites in particular, because you're, like you said, you're accidentally learning about other creatures. And if you strike me as somebody who's extremely curious, and so that must satisfy you very much.
Yeah. Well, I love what you were just saying about the microscopic world, because it's almost like this kind of like fractal experience, right? Where like every layer that you look at, there's more detail there than maybe you expected at first. And you can kind of just keep going down deeper and deeper into that. You could start like, you know, maybe looking at insects, which I always loved doing as a kid. And you're like, oh, there's these cool bugs. I could flip over a rock and find these things. And then you find out like, oh, well, if I take a magnifying glass to that, there's even smaller things that I wasn't seeing. Oh, if I take that into a microscope, there's even these other things there. And yeah, I mean, I love what you were saying about like looking at pond water or something. Like people watch these, documentaries of like the African savanna. And I'm like, that level and of drama is playing out around us all the time at these like smaller scales. But it's just as dramatic or even more dramatic, I think, because like, you know, you might be watching these like copepods and ostracods eating each other, and then like a dragonfly nymph will come out of nowhere. And that's like a Tyrannosaurus rex to these like small things. And then like a fish could come by, and that's like, you know, we don't even have the scale variation of that in the vertebrate world. That would be like, you know, a whale coming up and eating something. Then it's like, and that just goes so many levels up and down in the microscopic world. It's super cool. And the last thing I'll say is most of animal diversity is like less than 5 millimeters long. You know, if you were to count up like all the animal species in the world and put them on a line by their size, like more than half of animal species are these small things. So we're just biased as humans because we're on like the big end of the spectrum. But, you know, the vast majority of animal life and life on this planet is small things that are small to us, things that we really need a microscope to look at.